नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमम् देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत्। नष्टप्रायेषु भद्रेषु नित्यं भागवतसेवया भगवति उत्तमश्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी। टेन चैप्टर 10 कैंटो चैप्टर 13 श्लोक नंबर 1। श्री शुक उवाच साधु पृष्ठं महाभाग त्वया भागवतोत्तमा यन्नो तन्नय इष्यस्य शृण्वन्नपि कथामुहु। श्रील सुखदेव गोस्वामी सेड, ओ बेस्ट ऑफ डिवोटीज, मोस्ट फॉर्चुनेट परीक्षित, व्हाट वर्ड, ओके। श्री शुक उवाच, सुखदेव गोस्वामी सेड, साधु पृष्ठम, आई हैव बीन वेरी मच ऑनर्ड By your inquiry, Mahabhaga, you are a greatly fortunate personality. Tvaya, by you, Bhagavatottama, O best of devotees, Yad, because, Nutanayasi, you are making newer and newer. Ishasya, of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Shrinvanapi, although you are continuously hearing Katham, the past times, Muhu, again and again. Srila Sukhdev Goswami said, O best of devotees, most fortunate Parikshit, you have inquired very nicely, for although constantly hearing the pastimes of the Lord, you are perceiving His activities to be newer and newer. Purport by Srila Prabhupada. Unless one is very advanced in Krishna consciousness, one cannot stick to hearing the pastimes of the Lord constantly. Nityam nava navayamanam. Even though advanced devotees hear continually about the Lord for years, they still feel these topics are coming to them as newer and fresher. Therefore, such devotees cannot give up hearing of the pastimes of Lord Krishna. Premanjana churita bhakti vilochanena santa sadaiva hridayeshu vilokayanti. The word santa is used to refer to persons who have developed love for Krishna. Yam shama sundaram achintya guna swarupam govindam adi purusham tamaham bhajami. Brahma Samhita 5.38. Parikshit Maharaj therefore is addressed as Bhagavatottama, the best of devotees, because unless one is very much elevated in devotional service, One cannot feel ecstasy from hearing more and more and appreciate the topics as ever fresher and newer. ॐ अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपकदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरो श्रीयुतापदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं सागजातं सहगणरघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवम् साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपदान् सहगणलिता शाकान्वितांश्च नमामि विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामीति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वतीदेवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे नमो महावदन्याय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनाम्ने गौरतुष्ये नमः हे कृष्णकरुणासिन्धो दीनबन्धो जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिकाकान्त राधाकान्त नमोऽस्तु भक्तकाञ्चनगौराङ्गी राधे वृन्दावनेश्वरी शभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च पासिन्धुभ्य एव च तानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासदि गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। So you all know these pastimes of Lord Krishna and you are residing in this most holy of places just next to Giriraj Govardhan. And you know all the names of the places where the Lord performed his pastimes. Especially next to Govardhan. So I remember once we were coming on Yatra with His Holiness Radhanath Maharaj and there was Sachinandan Maharaj also. So we were we got down from the bus and we were walking and there was thorns, you know, on the road and very constantly we were being, you know, getting these thorns on our feet. And we had some difficulty in walking. But later on we read about that these thorns, Bhaktivinoda Thakur or some acharya was saying that these thorns that we are, you know, pricking our feet, they are the greatest ecstasy. Prabodhanand Saraswati, yes. So, of course, we did not realize that. So then we reached that place and Maharaj was saying some names which of course we did not understand at that time. But later on sometime we read about that. So he was saying Munjatavi. So that was a place where there were so many demons which were sent by Kamsa to kill Lord Krishna. So one of these places was this, some acharyas say that there was a demon who was in the form of this fire or Davanala. And some acharyas say that it was a fire which came spontaneously like that. So my understanding is Munja means a forest of bamboos. And sometimes when there is friction between these bamboos, then there is a fire that is produced, and then the whole forest starts burning. So all these coward boys, they were with Krishna, and they had come over there, and they were enjoying with Krishna. So our acharya has explained Krita Punya Punja. They had performed this so many pious activities over so many lifetimes. And that is why they had got this opportunity to play with Lord Krishna as a friend. So they were very happy, performing so many wonderful sports with Krishna. So all the sports that we see in this material world, they are all the reflection of the sports which are happening in Goloka, in the spiritual world with Krishna. Here it is only a perverted reflection. Here there is competition, they are thinking, I should defeat this person, like this. But there everyone is thinking how I can give more pleasure to Krishna. So there is not that sense of competition over there. The competition is there in the sense they want to give more pleasure to Krishna. Whereas here it is a selfish type of competition that I want to be the best. Somehow I should defeat the other person. Somehow I should. But there, that is why the spiritual world, because there is no envy, there is every moment there is more and more bliss. Like here it is explained, Nava Navayavamanam. Every moment there is everything becomes more and more fresh, because their desire is to serve Krishna in newer and newer ways, and so Yoga Maya arranges for them to think of newer and newer ways to serve Krishna. So our acharyas, they hear only a sort of synopsis is given, a very short type of, sort of like a summary. But then our acharyas explain or expand it and explain that what different things each of those coward boys used to do, how they would arrange so many types of beds for Krishna to lay down on, and Krishna would lie down on each of the beds. And each gopa would think Krishna is only with me. Krishna is only, reciprocating with me. So Krishna is unlimited. He can expand unlimitedly and reciprocate with each of those coward boys. So he was doing that. And they were very happy there. But then suddenly this fire broke out. And whenever there is any problem, whenever there is any asura or any demon that comes there, they immediately they cry out to Krishna, "Pahi, Pahi, Mahabahu," like that. So they started calling out to Krishna, but they were also feeling very afraid that Krishna will be, affected by this. And they were very worried that what will happen to Krishna because of this fire. Although in one sense they had confidence that Krishna will do something, Krishna will, remove this problem. But at the same time they had a great anxiety also, that what will happen to Krishna, what will this fire do to Krishna? So this type of a double, emotion is always there in Vraja. When the coward boys or in any leela of Krishna, whenever there is some problem whenever there is like Kalia Leela was there, so there also, so Krishna is fighting with the Kalia, but at the same time they are also feeling that, you know, what will happen to Krishna. So this type of double emotion is always going on in all the pastimes with Krishna. So here also, so Krishna could understand their anxiety. So he told all of them, now you close your eyes. And then all these coward boys, they close their eyes. And then Krishna just swallowed the whole fire. Dhavanalpana. Because he did not want them to feel anxiety that what will happen to Krishna. Because even if they were to see Krishna swallowing this fire, that would sort of again give them some anxiety whether, you know, because of that something will happen to Krishna by taking this fire. So Krishna wanted to allay their anxiety. So Krishna immediately swallowed the entire fire, and then they, when they opened their eyes, then they saw that everything was normal. They became very happy. So this happened at that place. Atavi, I think, is forest, right? No, so Munja Atavi. So that was the first time I heard Maharaj speaking those words with Sachinandan Maharaj. So all these places Maharaj knows very, all the names, you know. But we were very new, so we did not know all that. And then after that, we had, we visited many places. And in the evening then, we went to the place where Brahma Vimohan Leela was performed. Lord Brahma, he stole all the calves and cows and the coward boys, and he put them in a cave, and he, that place we visited with Maharaj. And then we had Chaumua is a place, I think, where So Chaumua is a place where Brahma came later and apologized to Krishna and offered his prayers. And then with his four heads, he offered obeisances. And all his four heads touched the ground. We don't know how he did that. So that's why that place is called Chaumua. So that place, I don't think we had visited in Yatra, but I visited that place separately with some relative. And there is some very nice development going on there now also. Generally, that place is quite secluded kind of, although there are a lot of residences now over there, but hardly much activity there. So they have built a lot of this Adityanath. He has built a lot of nice structures there and garden and everything. So that is temple also, yeah. So Shukdev Goswami himself is a person who is Bhagavatottama. So he is constantly immersed in, you know, hearing about the Lord. And similarly, Parikshit also is a Bhagavatottama. So here it is explained, or here he is saying to Parikshit, Tvaya Bhagavatottama Yan Nutanayas Ishasya Shrinvan Api Kathamu. So because you are perceiving these pastimes of the Lord to be newer and newer, so I am also getting this you know, enthusiasm to narrate these pastimes so that you can relish them. So here, the next verse is, Paramahamsas, devotees who have accepted the essence of life are attached to Krishna in the core of their hearts, and He is the aim of their lives. It is their nature to talk only of Krishna at every moment, as if such topics were newer and newer. They are attached to such topics just as materialists are attached to topics of women and sex. So, here our acharyas explain that this nectar of the Lord's pastimes, how it is, you know, increasing more and more. So that they are in this shlokas, in this series of shlokas, there is a gradual increase in the nectar of the shlokas. So here there is a comparison with the material kind of rasa. In the material world, the highest, you know, pleasure is considered to be sex life. So here the also the pastimes of Lord Krishna with the gopis, they are said to be kama praya, because that is the best that we can understand. That is the highest that we can, you know, able to grasp. So that is why there it is said kama praya, that it is something like kama. But actually, prema is something completely different. It is like Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami says that it is like gold and iron. So their swarupa is completely different. So this attachment to Krishna is a completely spiritual thing. Whereas in this material world, again, it is like I scratch your back, you scratch mine, you know. If I want to enjoy, so I'll give you some enjoyment. So that is the kind of enjoyment that is there in this material world. But in the spiritual world, it is completely different. It is a superlative. So we can get some idea of that. Here we have some love towards, you know, either some people or something. Just like we may have some attachment, or we have a deep attachment to some relative, say our sister or a brother or mother or father or some cousin, you know, or some friend. So there we have a very, if we have a very strong attachment, so that is sort of, when it is selfless, then it is very close, or it has some touch of prema. So in this, why? Because it is selfless. In this material world, selfless, Prabhupada says, you can get an idea of that when you see the mother's love for the child. So similarly, this kind of love that is there in this material world, it is a reflection of what is there in the spiritual world. Because if that is not there in the spiritual world, it cannot exist over here. So here, in this material world, whatever love is there, it is a reflection of what is there in the spiritual world. So all the relationships here, with whatever our relations, you know, and also it can be with certain things, like say if someone is very attached to. Another example that is given is a businessman who is very attached to getting more and more money. Rupa Goswami gives this example. Just like here the example is given of Striya Vitanami Va Sadhuvar. Just like man is attached to woman. Similarly, a Vaishya or a businessman, he has, you know, tremendous greed for getting money. So it's like unending. Even though he has got so much amount of money, still his greed keeps on increasing. So here in this material world, or someone is interested in, say, you know, some kind of sports, or someone is interested in, say, management, you know, of a big empire, kind of business empire, or so this kind of thing someone may be very attached to. So then one can get an idea or a glimpse of the type of attachment that is there in the spiritual world. So that is why these comparisons are given over here, so that we can get an idea. But that is, here in the material world, it is very, very minute compared to what is there in the spiritual world. In the spiritual world, it is extremely, of an extremely high nature. That is why here, in this pastime, we can see how gradually Shukdev Goswami is building up to that, you know, level. So then he says, O King, kindly hear me with great attention. Although the activities of the Supreme Lord are very confidential, no ordinary man being able to understand them, I shall speak about them to you. For spiritual masters explain to a submissive disciple even subject matters that are very confidential and difficult to understand. So then, after saving the boys and calves from the mouth of Agasur, Lord Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, brought them all to the bank of the river and spoke the following words. My dear friend, just see how this river bank is extremely beautiful because of its pleasing atmosphere. Just see how the blooming lotuses are attracting bees and birds by their aroma. The humming and chirping of the bees and birds echoing throughout the beautiful trees in the forest. Also here the sands are clean and soft. Therefore, this must be considered the best place for our sporting and pastimes. So this is a prelude to how the Brahmavihar Lila happened. After Agasur was dispatched, or he was liberated by the Supreme Lord, the Lord brought all his coward friends to the bank of the river, and he said, oh, just see this wonderful atmosphere. This is very wonderful. And here in this beautiful forest of trees, we can perform our sporting pastimes over here. So they started performing the different types of pastimes. And Prabhupada writes here, Kujata Kokila Hamsa Sarasagana Kirne Mayurakule. Vrindavan forest always filled with chirping and cooing of birds like Kokila, Hamsa, Sarasa, Mayura. So here you have experience of that. This is the most, you know, now if you go to Vrindavan, it's very difficult. But here you can hear all that most of the time. At that time when Prabhupada started Krishna Balaram Mandir, so then there was you know, much more greenery over there and everything, so you could still hear all these wonderful sounds over there. But now it's become quite filled with this buildings and motor cars and everything. Still, one can, if one gets up very early and, you know, goes around a little bit, you can still hear. I think we should take our lunch here since we are already hungry because the time is very late. Here the cows may drink water and go slowly here and there and eat the grass. So then they started playing, and after some time naturally they became very fatigued and they decided now we'll take our lunch. So he said this is a nice place, they can go, the cows can go around and graze a little bit. And so accepting Lord Krishna's proposal, the cowherd boys allowed the cows to drink water from the river and then tied them to trees where there was green tender grass. Then the boys opened their baskets of food and began eating with Krishna in great transcendental pleasure. So they used to bring their different items from their home and they used to offer to Krishna. So they would take small items and they would, you know, give to Krishna and ask Krishna, just see this taste, this taste is so wonderful. And Krishna would laugh, yes, nice. So, and they would give to each other also. And sometimes what they would do, they would put jasmine flowers inside and give to Krishna. And Krishna would, ha. They would make a face and then they would start laughing. So the demigods were astonished to see what was going on. So naturally, they were thinking, how is it that these, you know, boys, they can play with the Lord like this? He only eats yajna bhuk, means he only eats those things which are offered in yajna with so many prayers and everything. So many mantra, tantra, mudra, puja. So only those things are accepted by the Lord. So how is it that he is accepting here directly from, and that also, you know, that has been tasted by them, jhuta. So that was very difficult for them to understand. And not only for them, it is even difficult for great yogis to understand this. So in Brahma Samhita, Lord Brahma is also saying that, but somehow he forgot about it. Muni Pungavanam. Shatavatsarasam. So, they were sitting, you know, like a whorl of a lotus surrounded by its petals and leaves. Krishna sat in the center, encircled by his friends, who all looked very beautiful. Every one of them was trying to look forward towards Krishna, thinking that Krishna might look toward him. In this way, they all enjoyed their lunch in the forest. So, here our acharyas explained that when they were trying to, you know, look towards Krishna, they were feeling as if Krishna is only looking towards them. So, although they were seated all around Krishna and they were looking towards Krishna, they were feeling as if Krishna is only looking towards me. So this is Krishna's achintya shakti. He can, you know, although he is one, he can be simultaneously exchanging his love with his all his devotees simultaneously. So among the cowherd boys, some place their lunch on flowers, some on leaves, some on fruits or bunches of leaves, some actually in their baskets, some on the barks of trees and some on rocks. This is what the children imagined to be their plates as they ate their lunch. So they made different plates, you know, and they with flowers, leaves, and fruits, bunches of leaves. So with that they made, you know, very quickly they used to make this and they used to keep their items, whatever they had brought, you know, chapatis and rice and, you know, different items. Oh, yeah. So, It used to be very wonderful to see how they would quickly make this. So even now, if you go to South India, or some other places in India also, in remote places, they make spoons out of the leaves. So like in our place in Kerala, no, they'll make it out of jackfruit leaf. They'll make spoon for eating the food. And it's very green, no? You can just throw it. Not like plastic, you have to spend so many hours. You have to make a machine for that, make plastic cups and this and that. And it lies there only, it never goes. So this is so fast. Bhojan, sorry. Yeah. When we had gone first time, when we had come, we were given this kullad. Everyone was surprised, are this is, made from earth, clay. So that they were astonished, because they are from all from Bombay. And not seen kullad. So all the cowherd boys enjoyed their lunch with Krishna, showing one another the different tastes of different varieties of preparation they had brought from home. Tasting one another's preparation, they began to laugh and make one another laugh. So different tastes here. Here the word that was used was, yeah, Mrushana Kavalam is dadi, means the curd rice. So Krishna is holding that curd rice in his hand. You have seen that photo, no? That famous photo is there where Krishna is holding. And there are pieces of fruit, just pickled fruit in between the fingers. Or they are there in the other hand like that. And mixes, and then he eats that. So that is very favorite of Krishna. There's different types of dadi odanam, another word that is used, rice and curd. So here the cows are also, everything in Vraja is, they are all persons. So they are great rishis and munis who have performed thousands of years of penance to get the opportunity to get to be with Krishna. So Krishna reciprocates with them. He is very much fond of stealing this, milk and butter and all this milk products. So it is actually the love that they have that is expressed in this form. And as in this, you have seen in Damodar Leela also how this milk itself is a person. So he's thinking, now what is the use of my, when Yashodamai is going to feed Krishna, so he tries to commit suicide by going out from this vessel. So among the cowherd boys, some placed their lunch on flowers, some on this is Krishna is Yajna book that he eats only offerings of Yajna, but to exhibit his childhood pastimes, he now sat with his flute tucked between his waist and his tight cloth, and horn bugle and cow driving stick on his left, holding in his hand a very nice preparation of yogurt and rice with pieces of suitable fruit between his fingers. He sat like a bowl of a lotus flower, looking forward towards his friends, personally joking with them and creating jubilant laughter among them as he ate. The denizens of heaven were watching, struck with wonder at how the personality of God, who eats only in yajna, was now eating with his friends in the forest. So, same thing happened with Lord Brahma also. Lord Brahma is thinking, how can this be the Supreme Lord? He only eats, you know, yajna bhog, and that also with the of the highest standard. Even that sometimes he may not accept. Even if your standard of, you know, offering to the Lord are very high, sometimes it may not be, there may be some small contamination. Then it is, you know, rejected. It's not accepted. Sometimes it happens in Jagannath Puri, right? So there they have this thing in which they see whether the Lord has accepted. So if there is, Lord has accepted, there will be an image in that ring or something. Yeah. So if that is not there, then the whole thing is rejected. Then they have to make again. So for Rajasuya Yajna and for so many different types of Yajna, there are so many high standards are there. So they are thinking how this is possible, how the Lord can accept. So Brahma also, he became bewildered. Of course, this is for the Lord to perform his pastime. There are many things that Lord did by doing this. So Brahma thought, okay, let me test the Lord. So what he did is he made the calves go away in another direction. And then the cowherd boys, they said, hey, where are the cows? So they became very anxious. Then Krishna said, okay, you wait over here, you just relax, I'll go and look for them. So then Krishna went after their cows, and in the meantime, Brahma came and he stole the cowherd boys also. And when Krishna came back, after looking, he could not find the cows because Brahma had taken them and hidden them in a cave. And when he came back, he saw the cowherd boys are also not there. Then immediately he could understand, oh, this is the work of Brahma. Okay, so Brahma went back to Brahmaloka and then he came back in a moment, means of Brahmaloka. But when he came back after a moment, here it became more than, it's almost a 1 year. But when he came back, he saw that all the same cowherd boys and all the cows which he had taken, they were all playing with Krishna. So he thought, hey, did I not do that? Did I not put them in the cave? So he went back and he looked in the cave. And there he saw there, they are there. All those cowherd boys and the cows and they are over there. So what is this set then, who are playing with Krishna? So he became completely bewildered. So Krishna, in the meantime, what he did is he expanded as all these cowherd boys and calves. And when he, not only that, in each of the ornaments and, you know, their different bugles and flutes, they all had their vetra and veni and everything. So, and the ropes for tying the calves, everything. So Krishna expanded as all of those things, exactly like they were. And then when he went back, the parents, they started to become very much attached to their children. They already had attachment to their children, but now that attachment increased unlimitedly. So they started to take very good care of them, and they started to feed them personally, and make special preparation for them, and they didn't want them to go to the forest. This was very astonishing, and this continued for almost a year, and only at the end of that, Balram, Krishna lifted the yoga maya, and Balram was able to understand, are something is different over here. Why these cows and calves, the cows are having so much affection for the cow, just like they are having for Krishna. And these cowherd boys also, why their parents are having so much affection for them, just like Yashoda has for Krishna. So how is this possible? So then he could understand. Then, because till then Krishna had even covered Balram with his yoga maya. So for practically almost a year, they were not able to realize this. So why Krishna wanted to actually give that bliss to the parents of the cowherd boys and also to the cows? Because they were also thinking whether we'll be able to somehow please Krishna, just like Yashoda is pleasing Krishna. We will be able to reciprocate directly with Krishna. And another thing also Krishna arranged, Purnamasi had told that when this particular age of Krishna will come, then we will get all these cowherd boys married to the cowherd girls. So that arrangement Krishna had arranged through yoga maya, that so that he would marry all the cowherd girls. So they were actually, all these cowherd boys were Krishna. So he married all these cowherd girls at that time. So in that sense also, Krishna is not performing anything, immoral when he is dancing with all the gopis, because he is married to them. Of course, Krishna is doesn't have to do like that, because that is that flavor of rasa that is called parakya rasa is made by yoga maya, so that they will think that we are the wives of someone else. To increase that attachment to Krishna and to increase his pastimes with the gopis. So like this, Krishna swabhaviki jnana valakriyacha. He can arrange so many different things simultaneously. So he performed that in this leela and in so many other leelas also. So when Brahma came back, he was completely, bewildered. He couldn't understand. And another acharya explains that another set of these cowherd boys, they were playing with Krishna at the same time also. So there were three sets. Brahma couldn't see the third set. He could see only the set of boys were and the cows were with Krishna. And he could only see the set which he had put inside the cave. But there was another set of cowherd boys and cows who were playing with Krishna. So Brahma became completely bewildered, and so that some of the acharyas of the Madhva Sampradaya, they don't comment on this Brahma Vimola Leela, because they, for them, Chaturmukha means that is the highest position, because after all the Vayus, they all reach the position of चतुर्मुख. सो फॉर देम दैट इज द हाइएस्ट पोजिशन. वी ऑल्सो नो दैट आफ्टर डूइंग 100 वर्णाश्रम धर्मस प्रॉपरली परफेक्टली वन कैन गेट द पोजिशन ऑफ ब्रह्मा. सो देयर सिस्टम इज दैट यू परफॉर्म वर्णाश्रम धर्म वेरी नाइसली एंड यू कैन अटेन द पोजिशन ऑफ वायु एंड लाइक दैट एंड आफ्टर दैट यू कैन बिकम अल्टीमेटली ब्रह्मा. And then you can get liberation, you can go to the spiritual world. So for them, they generally don't, you know, speak about Brahma Vimana, because them, for them, how can Acharya be in illusion? You know? So, but Krishna is, he can akartum kartum sarvata kartum, he can do anything. He can put a person like Brahma into illusion, and he can give full knowledge to a person who is very, you know, simple. Just like in South India, he gave this knowledge to one of the Alvars. He was a very simple person. Means he was hardly educated even, and he gave him such panditta that all these big scholars in the king's court, they were all defeated by him. So he has written this Divya Prabandham that is sung before the Lord. So that is Krishna's vaibhav. He can give his mercy to the smallest, most insignificant person, and he can put the most greatest person into illusion very easily. Just imagine, Balram himself couldn't understand. So when Brahma came back then and he surrendered to Krishna, then Krishna showed him all these coward boys, they are not ordinary, they are my forms. Then you could see they are all Chaturbhuja, all Vishnu forms. So Krishna is the original source of Vishnu also. Through this pastime, Krishna showed that. Hare Krishna.